नमस्कार। टुडे आई एम हियर विथ सम इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन सोलर एक्लिप्स दैट इज ऑकरिंग ऑन 14 दिसंबर 2020 एंड दिस इज द लास्ट सोलर एक्लिप्स ऑफ द ईयर एंड इट्स क्लियरली सीन इन चिली एंड अर्जेंटीना एंड पार्शली सीन इन साउथ अमेरिका एंड ब्राजील एंड इट्स नॉट एट ऑल सीन इन इंडिया। नाउ वेयर एग्जैक्टली इट इज, व्हेन एग्जैक्टली इट इज हैपनिंग? So on 14th December, that is Monday, and the grahana or the eclipse will start at 7:03 IST in the evening, that is 7 p.m., 3 minutes past 7 p.m. And it will end in the midnight, that is 12:23 a.m. on Tuesday, 15 December 2020. And the peak of this eclipse is around 9:43, 9:45 p.m. So again, as usual, you try to eat before 6 o'clock, and if possible, if that is not possible, at least don't go in for a very heavy dinner. And children, then pregnant women, and then senior citizens and people with health ailments need not follow it. But I would advise take early dinner and eat something really light. That will be good because it's a cosmic event and a lot of radiations will be there. Now, where it is happening? It is happening in Scorpio, that is Vrishchik Rashi, in a star called as Jyeshtha in Gandhanta. Now, this is a Ketu Grasta Grahana. It means Ketu is causing this solar eclipse. And the axis that is evolved over here is between the second house and the eighth house of natural horoscope or Kalapurusha's Kundali. Now, who is affected over here? See, always eclipse occurs either for sun or moon. So here in this eclipse, sun is involved. So who is sun? Sun is the brightest star that is closer to earth. There may be many bright stars, brighter stars than sun, but we are not very much discussing them because they don't rule our lives. Sun, in fact, rules all the life on this earth. We are alive only because of sun. So I don't have to elaborate on that. Now, sunlight... or sun, actually it is sunlight, dispels the darkness. That is the nature of light. What is the nature of light? Completely dispelling the darkness. This darkness is not just the physical darkness we are talking about, but it is even the mental darkness or all our hidden things or whatever, like, you know, exposing the dark secrets and dark realms of mind and bringing them to surface, throwing the light on them. So that is what is the interpretation. In astrology, as we all know, sun is like a protector, he's a king, and he's a fatherly figure. All right. Now let us talk about Scorpio. It is happening in the eighth zodiac sign, that is Scorpio, right? Now what is this Scorpio? Scorpio rules the eighth house. I already said that it rules the eighth house of Kalapurusha's Kundali. It falls in the eighth house of Kalapurusha's Kundali. Now what is this eighth house? Eighth house is actually a house of death. It is called as Mrityusthana. Now, what is death? Death is not something only physically perishing. It is not just, something to fear. Death is actually a transformation. According to our Hindu philosophy, Atma never dies. Atma is an ansh of Paramatma. We are part and parcel of God. That is our fate. So, it is indestructible. We never die in that sense. Only we change our costumes, we go into the next dimension, we start our life all over again. That is again called as transformation. So we say 8th house is also a house of transformation. And then, you know, 8th house also is indicates a lot of hidden secrets and, you know, hidden knowledge also. Not just hidden secrets, hidden knowledge. Now, what do I mean by hidden knowledge? Hidden knowledge means it's like kind of a gudha vidya, what we call in Sanskrit. So all your astrology, then your tarot card reading, crystal ball gazing, or, you know, hypnosis, and then your neuro-linguistic programming, that is NLP, your PLRT, past life regression therapy, astrology, all these things are, you know, in the inner realms of mind, and these are called as hidden sciences. Something not everybody will understand, something not everybody will not be able to throw light on. So you need to work hard. So that is the house of death, what I'm talking about, what I'm discussing. And also it indicates gain through property, ancestral property, or you know, getting money through LIC, or getting money through your will of your father, grandfather, etc., or suddenly from somewhere, sudden gain. So it indicates that what it indicates. I mean, you know, this is the 8th house. Now I also mentioned second house. Second house is called as Kutumbasthana or family house. Now what do we mean by this? This basically rules, I mean, talks about our very close-knit family where we are staying, our own spouse, children, parents, siblings, whatever, very close-knit relations. And also second house rules over your food habits and your speech, Vani ka sthan, okay, Bhojan ka sthan, what kind of, if you study the second house properly, we can say whether people like sour food, whether people like cold and stale food, or whether people like hot food, and whether people like freshly prepared food. All these things can be studied. Astrology is a very interesting subject to study. Anyway, now, like talking about Scorpio. Scorpio, I discussed that all dark secrets, dark unknown realms of mind, and then I called it as house of transformation. But now you also have to remember that this Scorpio sign is a watery sign. Jala tattva ki rashi hai. Now, what do I mean by this? You know, the main element considered over here is water. And who is the ruler for this? Mars. Mars or Mangal. Now, what is Mars? Mars is a warrior. He's a young man, aggressive, and, you know, senapati bolte hai usko. So he is all filled with action, action oriented. So that is a combination for this Vrishchik Rashi. But Vrishchik Rashi is also called as a negative sign for Mangal. So actually Mars planet rules two houses, that is one Aries and one the Scorpio. So Aries is his positive house, and I mean, you know, Vrishchik or I mean Scorpio is his negative house. So this house, when gets activated, water element comes to prominence. So element of water coming to prominence, what do I mean? Now you can relate it with the eclipse. It's a very, very logical and a scientific thing you can study, you know. So when this house gets activated, water element comes to prominence. What do I really mean by this? It means in the forthcoming rainy season, you could expect a lot of heavy rains, and then tsunami, and a lot of floods, and a kind of property damage, and livestock damage, life damage in general, I would say. And then road and air transport is definitely going to get affected if there is so much of water flowing on the earth, right? That is one thing. Now, another thing is, I also spoke about transformation. This might transform the way waterways operate. Maybe the cargo system, some changes may come, good or bad, we don't know, we have to wait and watch. So transportation through water also would get affected and will go undergo some kind of transformation. And not just that, even like, you know, there is a warlike situation that may arise through water borders. So all the countries will get very protective, very cautious to maintain their water border, which means our naval forces have to work very hard. If a war situation occurs through sea or through waterways, then who is going to be most involved in that? Action-packed people will be Navy people. So these kind of situations are seen. And all the countries will be very vigilant and very, well-prepared. And they will be really worried to protect their own borders and their own things because of this. Now, water, I spoke about this. Now, it is also connected with emotion. See, about if you take physically, about 75% of our entire body is water only, the blood and the serum or whatever liquid parts are there in our body. So it's all about water. But this also rules a lot of emotions. So water is typically associated with emotions. Now, people may suffer from emotional distress or disturbance in this due to this effect of this grahana, because it is also happening in gandanta, nakshatra gandanta. Okay, so emotional disturbances and a sort of depression, lack of enthusiasm, you can very well relate. Now what this COVID situation has led us to, we are trying to keep our spirits very high, we are trying to work hard, But there is always a kind of a scare within, and there is some sense of insecurity. See, if you're staying home, that is another kind of depression. If you're going out, there is another kind of a situation you're facing. You're so scared to mingle with people. I mean, you are always worried about your safety. If you're forced to go to work, you don't know what's going to happen. So that kind of a mental trauma, I won't call it as trauma, but you know, a kind of mental depression state. So grahana, this eclipse may enhance that effect. Eclipse begins in Jyeshtha. I just spoke about Gandhanta, right? So what is this Gandhanta? Eclipse begins in Jyeshtha, that is Jyeshtha Nakshatra or Jyeshtha star. This star is ruled by Mercury and it ends in Moola. Moola Nakshatra comes in Sagittarius, which is a fiery sign, begins in a watery sign, that is Scorpio. And Moola Nakshatra is ruled by Ketu. So Ketu Grasa Grahana becomes more powerful here. And like again, Sagittarius is a fiery sign. Now just imagine what happens when you bring water and fire together. Naturally, there'll be steam. Okay. Now this steam, that is why I said emotional upheaval, that's also kind of steam that is inbuilding in you, and also a period of confusion. And this steam actually could be like what results out of due to fire and water. This steam would be more dangerous and the effects are felt deeper than fire itself. So one need to be very cautious. So now what is, I mean, how long the effect is going to last? The effect is definitely going to last for next 6 months, according to me. What is the general advice I would like to give? Whatever may be your moon sign or sun sign, you may not even know your moon sign. Let's see. One need to be absolutely cautious. Don't get carried away by any external stimulants or any external pressure, because there is a indication that everyone may get swayed with those emotions. So be very careful and be very cautious before you tread into any new realm. And best thing is to trust your own intuition and your own reflection. That always helps, you know. And don't get influenced by others. Like, say, for example, if your friend comes and says, I'm starting a business, come and he will show a very big picture and a presentation. No, we are going to make this much money. We are going to get this. Don't get carried away. Think over very thoroughly. Study the project. Only if you feel sense, you invest it. Otherwise, don't go in for investment. Otherwise, next 6 months, take the things easy. Don't get into a lot of changes or a lot of investment. Now, this, there is one typical question people keep on asking me. If the eclipse is not seen, then we are not to be affected, right? And even some astrologers also believe that if the eclipse is not seen, we are not affected. It is not like that, according to me, little what I have understood and what I have studied astrology. See, this is happening all across the universe, right? This is a universal phenomena. So if it is seen, then the effects are 100%. If it is not seen, then maybe around 50 to 60%. But we cannot say that there are no effects at all. Effects are definitely going to be there. Another question people ask is, see, now the solar eclipse is happening in the evening time. Generally, it happens during the daytime. So we are not to worry, right? It is not for us. See, eclipse is not like, you know, to be bargained for me or for you. It's not. It's a universal thing. Whether you want it or not, the effects are going to be there. Less or more depends on the proximity where it is occurring. Yes, in India, we are not able to see the eclipse, but still 50 to 60% will be there. Effects will be there. And also, it is happening late in the evening after Suryasta or after sunset. But see, the phenomena is, sun is set for us in India, but he's not set for the entire world, right? So he's going on completely, moving around. So you will get some results, 50 to 60%. Now, I am going to discuss in brief about how it's going to affect each moon sign. Okay. And see, this is again a general prediction. It depends on the position of planets in your own horoscope. So you don't have to take everything what I say happens with everybody. It depends on the position of planets in your horoscope. You need to relate to that. If you have little knowledge of astrology, if you are a student of astrology, you can relate to that. Otherwise, don't get worried. Take it as a caution and then proceed. And one more thing I would like to tell you. I will discuss in general very briefly about each moon sign. In my last video of related to eclipse, I have given you certain remedies or mantras, you know. So they apply for all the eclipses as such, because during eclipse, what you have to pray is, like, you have to pray for to Rahu and Ketu. These are very important. And then your own ruler, the planet that controls your own zodiac sign. So these things, please refer to the earlier video. Otherwise, it will become very lengthy. I don't want to go on and on. So quickly now, let me take you through the moon signs. So we are talking of Aries. For Aries, it is not very good. And it gives a kind of inauspicious thing, especially as far as your health is concerned. Be very, very careful about your health. Otherwise, you will end up in a mess. So in the next 6 months, any warning signal, any little thing happening, also go for investigations, take proper care, and, you know, whatever mode of medicine you believe, go for that. And at workplace and at home, be very, very cautious and careful. Don't let your ego rule you. Next 6 months, please keep your ego aside and think through and then talk. Because Mesh Rashi people are very, it's an aggressive sign, and they, you know, they just barge into. They don't get into analyzing and then talking. They talk and then finish it off. Don't do that. So be cautious. Now, Taurus people, like, again, a mixed results over here. You may face a problem in your business and partnership. Partnership also is not just a business partnership. It talks about your spouse also. So be cordial and be cautious in your relation with your life partner, that is a marriage partner, husband or a wife, whatever. But see, what happens is marriage is also like a project. You need to work towards it. You check on the earth, no marriage is completely ideal. Now we have to make efforts, because you come from a different background, spouse come from a different background, and not just the background of your family on this earth, you come from your different Atma Sanskar, what we call, your conditioning of your Atma. It is totally different. Your aspirations are different. Your partner's aspirations are different. If you want to make it work together, then you will have to understand each other and accept each other what it is. So that you need to be very careful, Rishabh Rashi people, and handle with patience and calmness. Everything will be fine. And work-related problems, if you are having, if you are in a job and you are facing some problem, if you are already in a business and facing some problem, they will resolve. There is a possibility that they resolve. And then Gemini or Mithun Rashi people, it is actually good. This Grahana is good for them. All your problems related to your property and the court cases will get resolved, and your enemies will come to surface. See, sometimes what happens is enemies are just around us, roaming in the garb of your friends. You think they are your great friends and you do everything and they are so nice on your face, but they may be backstabbing you or they may be really trying to harm you. So all these things will come to surface. So then you will be able to take your call, and either you eliminate those toxic people from your life or you handle them in a particular way. That is for Mithun Rashi people. Karka Rashi people, again, mixed results you are having. Not too bad also, and not good also. That kind of a thing. Karka Rashi or Cancer sign, your children, it's good for your children. They may do well, and you know, they may prosper, they may get good results in their examinations or whatever they have undertaken, or they may get a promotion. Good for your children. But as far as your love matter or whatever is considered, if marriage is on your mind, if you're in the process of finalizing a marriage, please wait for next 6 months. And then you realize whatever it is, if it is good, then you can go ahead. And you need to be cautious, you know, with your spouse again. Be careful. And another thing is, like, you know, if you are a student and studying up any course and all that, you may have to put in a lot of effort, because success for Cancerians students is not going to come very easy this year due to this eclipse, especially in the next 6 months, because when you are heading towards your examination, you may have to put your 200% effort. That's all. No need to get scared. Now, Leo people, that is Simha Rashi, again, it's a mixed result, like, you know, not very good, but good kind of a thing, you know, not bad also, bad either. For Leo people, you need to be very careful about your mother's health. There is a chance that they will end up in some kind of a health issues or health problems. So nothing to worry. What you need to do is the minute you see any warning signs or signals, please treat them, take them to the doctor and get the investigation done and take good care of your mother, I would say. And, you know, you will find some kind of relief. If you are facing any problems in the court cases or your job problem or anything, those things will get sorted out for you. But there is a caution for your health. Simrashi people, Leo people, if you are having any heart ailment, if you are having hypertension, or if you are having any other kind of, recurring disease or whatever, so you need to really, really be cautious. Don't neglect yourself at all, that I would say. Next is Virgo. Virgo is having actually not very auspicious or not very good, but good, fairly good results they will get. And Virgo people will find success in profession and job. You know, what do I mean by this? If you are already aspiring for a position, maybe you will get your promotion. Or if you are already on the top bracket, then you may get a good increment. You know, those kind of things are there. But there is a mental stress due to, some issues in the family. So you need to sort them out. And you may also get some differences with your brothers and sisters, especially if you are in a business, if you are running a family business with your own brother or with your own sister. So be a little careful and handle each other with patience, I would say. It depends on what zodiac sign your sibling is going to have. Then next is Libra. Libra is having again kind of bad, but not very bad, not very good either. Okay, mixed results, I would say. There again, for them, financial matters and financial problems, or property matters, they will get sorted out for Librans. But there will be some kind of mental unrest in the family. Maybe, you will get worried about your son or worried about your partner or worried about your, anybody who is very close-knit family. So you need to take care of that. And also you might, if you are in a business, you may have some trouble with your business partner, so you need to be careful in that zone also. And for Scorpio people, it is not very good. Actually, it is happening in their own nakshatra gandanta. It is happening. I explained what does that mean. So Scorpio people, you need to be extremely careful about your health. So any small sign also you need to attend to. Don't neglect it. And be careful with your partner especially and your near and dear ones. And try to hold on. Try to curb your rash instinct of talking something or taking some rash decision. So that I would say. So nothing to worry. Take good care of your health. Sagittarius people also are having mixed results. Not very bad. It's a kind of inauspicious, but not very inauspicious, I would say. So for Sagittarius people also, enemies will surface. In a sense, their hidden enemies will be exposed. You come to know who is who and who is trying to trouble you. And one thing what I would say is, eclipse is happening in the 12th house for these Sagittarius people. Sagittarius is the 9th zodiac sign. And 8th is the Scorpio. Scorpio, it is happening. And Ketu is causing this Grahana. Ketu Grasa Grahana. Now, there is a complete aspect of Rahu, 7th aspect of Rahu, diagonally opposite, right? So, whenever 12th house operates due to Rahu, there is a kind of possibility of imprisonment or Bandhana Yoga. So, Sagittarius people, you need to be very, very careful. If by choice or by not choice, like if you are engaged in some kind of illegal thing or, you have taken something casually, tell you what happens, I'll take risk or whatever. Be careful, and if any such court cases are going on or if you have come into any such zone, so please try to settle it out of court and finish it off, because next 6 months are really, really going to be harsh on you. So you need to be very careful in that matter. And, avoid any illegal transaction also. So it might backfire. So that is one caution I would like to give to Dhanu Rashi or Sagittarius people. Then Makara Rashi is having again a good result, but not very good, kind of mixed good results. So for Makara Rashi people, you need to be careful with your business partner, especially if your business partner is also your friend. So you need to have one eye of suspicion and also control your words and control the other person also. Then nothing as such to worry. You will get business opportunities, but I would suggest hold on before entering into new zone. Say, for example, if you're already running a business, you want to do something else. You want to start something parallel. So try to hold on for 6 months. Study the papers, study the possibility, and you know, make a survey, everything. And then with your wide eyes open, then after 6 months, if you get into the business, maybe you will succeed. So be careful about that. And money flow is good, I would say, but it's not as per your expectation. Maybe like you are expecting a X amount, you may end up getting X by 2 or X by 3, in the sense little less or lesser than whatever your expectation. But it doesn't happen that you are not going to get anything only. It doesn't happen that way. Flow of money will be there and your business problems will also ease out, but not to the extent of what you are aspiring or what you are hoping. Okay. Then the next Rashi is the Kumbh Rashi. Kumbh Rashi people, it is really good. One caution for Kumbh Rashi people is your father's health may get affected. So again, don't ignore any small ailments, what your father complains or what health problems surface. So please take their due care and, you know, get them for testing and sort it out properly. That is one thing. And but, you know, success in your profession or work, a promotion is already indicated. Name and fame also is indicated. See, sometimes what happens, you're already in the top-notch bracket. You may not get anything further. So maybe you will get a decent salary hike, or maybe your company will offer you certain shares. But there will be recognition for you in your own company. That is the fame and name, what I'm talking about. So if you have done a big project for the company, everyone in the top will know that that has happened because of you. So that is there for this Kumbh Rashi people. Overall, this eclipse will bring good results for you. And Meen Rashi is again Mishra Shubha Phala. So there'll be a lot of gain, dhanalaba, or gain of money, especially through, you know, foreign collaborations. So what do I mean by this? Maybe you are engaged in a trade, you know, and you are engaged in working for MNCs. So success is seen through those things, and sources of income will increase and money also will flow properly. That is for Meena Rashi. So my predictions are based on this moon signs. See, again, I keep on telling you this in every time I speak about astrology. It is a very, very vast science. So nobody can claim mastery. I'm not claiming any mastery. Yes, it is a very fascinating science, and I study it, and whatever knowledge I have, I'm sharing with you all. And all of you, you know, refer to my previous videos on eclipse and chant the mantras for Rahu, Ketu and your own ruler planet, and everything will be fine. Eclipses come only for showing a path to us so that we can avoid if there is any hurdle. It's not to get scared or put you down or punish. So the eclipse is not a punishment. It's not for punishing us. It only shows us the way. Say, for example, if you're, you know, driving a vehicle and there is a huge speed breaker or there is a boulder. So what you do, if there is a speed breaker, you slow your vehicle and then move ahead. Or if there is a boulder, you circumvent and go. It is as simple as that. So if you know that there is something coming up, some problem is going to come up, then you will be having that preparation for that. So take it that way. And Shubham Bhavatu, God bless you. And pray to Lord. I pray that everyone is blessed in this universe. So Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani, Pashyantu Ma Kashchit Dukha Bhag Bhavet. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Thank you.